How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good times that made us laugh outweigh them.
Hello and welcome to Outlandish. Normally you see me up in the camera reaching out to you guys. You know, it's fun. I love having those kind of crazy shows and doing shows. But today is a very special day. You've seen me cover Eliana, and I've talked about April Tinsley in the past on the show, you know, with linking the kid murders of everything that's been going on, that's wrong with this world and wrong with the area of Fort Wayne. But this is April Tinsley's 25th anniversary, and this is her balloon release, and we're going to film everything. We're going to go more than what the news would ever do. We're going to film the whole entire event, even if we have to get it in segments and stuff. We're getting this whole event. We're going to stay for it because you know what? This girl needs, she's got everybody supporting her for finding out who the killer is, and everybody's got her back, and the family's back on everything. And we're going to stay here for the whole entire event to show everybody know we're here for, and this show right here in the event is dedicated to April Tinsley. And I got a special interview with her uncle, Jim Tinsley. How are you doing, sir?
Pretty good, pretty good.
Same here now. How are you linked to April, and can you give us a little bit of the timeline of what happened?
It was back in April 1st of 1988. My wife now, we were girlfriend boyfriend at the time, and we just got through working a double shift at work, and we come home, and I popped open a bottle of beer, and I laid on the couch and rest a little bit, and I seen this little banner going across the TV about April Tinsley missing. And I looked, and I hollered for my wife now, Debbie. I says, "Honey, come here." I says, "Check me if I'm seeing things." And she looked at us and goes, "Yeah, that's April. We got to get over there and find out what's going on." So we drove over there and found out she'd come up missing that day. She was with a girlfriend of hers, I guess, and they went to her house, and they were on their way back to the house. And when they got back, she forgot her umbrella. So she went back to get her umbrella, and that was the last time everybody had seen her on that day. And then 3 days later, they found her battered body where she had been raped and brutally, you know, murdered over there in DeKalb and Allen County line in the rain-filled ditch. That's where they found her at. And it's been broadcast on the news, America's Most Wanted, and it's been, you know, up to this time, you know, I mean, they've been pulling in leads, bringing in suspects and people for DNA. They have been, you know, I mean, working hard on this. And I couldn't believe it, you know. And I mean, actually, they even pulled me in one time for DNA, and they even went down to Mike and Janet and got their DNA, you know, because they thought maybe, you know, they had something to do with it, because they didn't show a lot of emotional, you know, on this. And I mean, my gosh, they just lost their daughter. How are they supposed to react, you know? So anyway, about 3 months ago, Michael and I was talking on the phone, and he got an idea. He goes, "I'd like to do something special for April's 25th anniversary of her death." And I got, "Huh, okay, what do you got in mind?" He goes, "I was thinking some kind of a tribute, you know, like maybe a balloon release or a candlelight vigil, something like that matter." I says, "Well, how about if we do a balloon release?" He says, "Well, you think you can get it done there in Fort Wayne, since that's where she's from?" I says, "I'm gonna do everything I can. I mean, I'm gonna make all the phone calls to everybody that I can get involved, find out where I go to, you know, to find out exactly how I can get all this rolling." And sure enough, I mean, I went through the mayor's office, I went through the permit office, airport authorities, and, you know, everybody gave me the green light. And then I got it done. We wanted to do it at Lakeside Park, and we got it thinking, you know, because since it was a public park, there's nothing that really could be done about it. And I got it thinking, well, what about Memorial Stadium or come here at Tin Caps at Parkview Field? And he got it thinking, he goes, let's try Parkview. I said, okay. So I got a hold of a young lady here named Jennifer. I can't think of what her last name is right now, but I talked to her, and I explained to her what was going on, and she goes, well, can you meet with me? And I says, well, sure. So I come over here and met with her, and she come over here and said, well, we got the amphitheater here. You're more than welcome to use. We'll donate that for you. So you can have me in. And she goes about how many people you're expecting. Right now, the way it stands, I'm looking at maybe 200. But that's what we're calculating, if not more. So other than that, I hope everything turns out to be a great day today.
The weather is nice, and
oh, yes.
People are slowly coming. I mean, this is I don't know what time it is right now, but sorry if I'm not trying to be a professional, but it's...
Yeah, I know. Mine is ringing, too.
It's like, it's 2:32, and the event starts at what time again?
It's supposed to go at 3:45.
At 3:45, and people are slowly showing up, and, 2:45. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Yeah,
2:45. Okay,
4:30. Yeah, we was going to have it from 2:30 to 4:30, a two-hour event. But like I said, I emailed the mayor's office, and I sent him an invitation, personal invitation, for him to come down for a 15-minute speech. And he emailed me back and said he sends his regrets that, you know, he wouldn't be able to make it because of a scheduling conflicts, and he sends his regards. And I thanked him for it, and then I have the pastor, I believe it's from the Faith United Methodist Church. I can't think of what her name is. Oh, Lord, she's going to kill me if she gets here.
going through the events, you know, and booking stuff and trying to make things work proper, you know, understand, you know, it's tough to keep something, especially when in somebody's memory, you want to try your best to show your hard work and dedication. Now, throughout the years with this going on, and, you know, you hear about it on TV, on Facebook, or, you know, around about the whole April Tinsley case, I mean, throughout the years, how did you cope with that?
Well, sometimes it's not easy because it seems like it just happened yesterday, you know. And you get people, you know, they see you on the street. Hey, I saw you on TV. You're the guy that was on the radio, you know. And it's kind of hard because, you know, it puts tears in the eyes, you know, thinking about it, you know, because the person out there is still there. You know, I mean, the law's doing everything they can. I mean, like I said, they're popping on leads as soon as they get them. I mean, the phone lines, I mean, like here, I mean, once this is over with, I bet $1 million that phone lines are going to be lit up like crazy.
Oh, yeah.
You know, for tips and information and, you know, all kinds of good things like that, which is great. Because, like I said, maybe not in my lifetime, and like Michael said, not in his lifetime, because he's done had 8 heart attacks already, you know, because of all the stress and strain he's going through over this.
And Mike's relation to April?
Yeah, that's her father.
Oh, okay.
That's my brother. That's my youngest brother, because the baby brother was killed back in, I can't remember, 84. And so Michael's the youngest brother I got. And it's April's dad, and like I said, he's had 8 heart attacks, and you know, and they've been through hard, you know, it's been rough for them. People don't realize it. They don't think, well, you know, well, they don't miss her. They, you know, they don't do the, you know, they're not sorry, or they don't regret it. It's all fake because I've lived with them. I know what it's like. I lived with them when they was on William Street.
You were there with them.
Oh yeah, boy. Before I met my wife, I lived with them when April was 7 years old. Because it was from from 4 years, when she was 4 years old to 7 years old, I believe. I stayed with them, and you know, I mean, she was a good kid. She was good natured. She never hurt, you know, never hurt nobody, she had friends that come around and, you know, and they go play and, you know, other than that, I mean, she was just a good-natured child. You know, she never meant no harm to nobody. And I can't understand what deranged idiot would do such a thing.
Not nowadays, and, you know, back then, just people that deal with stuff with kids, like, you know, with that stuff, that's just wrong, because I've always said this before, kids can't defend themselves. I think it's pretty pathetic that a human man or woman tries to take advantage of a kid, no matter what, and that's just wrong.
Right. Well, Michael and I, you know, like when we talked about this, you know, we told him, says, mainly it's April's Day, okay? But it not only for April, too, it's all for the other children that were, you know, brutally murdered and sexually assaulted by deranged idiots out there, you know? So the balloons are going to be for everybody, not just for April, too, you know? And the ones we got for April, we have little cards put on them, you know, it says on there, it says, if found, and it has a website to contact to find out, you know, where the balloons had been found, you know, not where we know how far they're gone. And from Facebook, from Michael and other friends I've talked to on Facebook, this thing's going practically national, even Canada. I got a friend in Canada that says Ontario, Toronto, Ottawa, Canada, everybody, even Augusta, Georgia, Tennessee, Kentucky, California, Austin, Texas, you know, they're all going to be involved. Everybody exactly 4:30 is going to reach the balloons. And they think 4th of July was a fun night. Today it's going to be great. I just hope it just turns out great, you know, because the weather's nice. I hope the folks come out, you know. I mean, we got 500 balloons. If they want to bring their own, you know, that was okay too. You know, her favorite colors were pink, blue, and purple. You know, so we're hoping everything turns out real good today. You know, so
I'm glad to be here, part of history, and thanks for having me, and thanks for letting me interview you. This has been one of my I've done shows throughout 19 years, and you know, with Aliana, and this has been one of my very emotional shows, and I appreciate you taking your time. And I know it's heartache and your dedication for letting me have you on my show. Thank you very much, Jim. You take it easy. We're going to see some more, the setup of the balloons being taken care of, and more interviews from the people in general, from family and everything else. This is going to be Outlandish April Tinsley's 25th anniversary balloon release. And Paul Brandt, I've said this several times, thank you very much for helping me out for today, because today is going to be a very emotional show. And I promise you, this is going to be the best show I've ever done in a while without the craziness. So stay tuned and you'll see some more interviews and a lot of people. And, you know, as a matter of fact, they're setting up for the balloon. If you can go over here, they're setting up a little bit for the balloons right here.
To you today. I chose the prayer that I love that is called a simple prayer, and it is actually the prayer of Saint Francis of Assisi. Those of you who are of the Catholic faith may know that we have our new Pope. Of course, all of us should know. Our new Pope is named St. Francis, and he got his name from St. Francis of Assisi, who wrote this prayer. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is discord, unity. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is error, truth. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is sadness, joy. Where there is darkness, light. O Divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love, for it is in giving that we receive. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned. It is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Now let us bow our heads for this prayer to April. O God, whose dear Son took little children into his arms and blessed them, give us grace, we pray, to entrust April to your never-failing love and care, and bring us all to your eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Do you want me to go ahead with the... And now I have been asked to read a poem by Michael Tinsley, April Never Forgotten. Sometimes it feels like I have been forgotten. I am only remembered 1 month out of the year. This makes me feel really rotten. In my eyes, there are some tears. It's been 25 years since my death. Left in a ditch beside the road. That's the day I took my last breath. My family saddened when they were told. My killer has yet to be brought to justice, and my soul is still not at rest. It has been such an evil injustice. To this day, there has been no arrest. Since the day of my brutal attack, my name was not of important fame. I have no statue or memorial plaque to be remembered or honored by name. Just some old newspaper clippings, an occasional spot on nightly news, with eyes that are still dripping, waiting for some new vital clues. The eyes of all my family members remember the sad day of my abduction. Sad hearts still remember my murder, rape, and seduction. Just a regular headstone now marks my earthly grave as I'm sitting beside my Lord's throne, which has my name engraved. Let the children come unto me, for such is the kingdom of heaven. Those are the words of Jesus. And to your love, we commend the sorrowing parents and family of April Tinsley. Show compassion to them as a father to his children. Comfort them, Lord, as a mother her little ones, as their love follows their heart's treasure. Help them to trust that the love they once have known, the love they've had in their hearts for April is never, ever lost. That the child taken from their sight lives forever in your presence. And now if we would all join in the Lord's Prayer before we release the balloons. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. this day comes after Easter, the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so as we release these balloons, we release them into heaven. We release them into love, into peace, into joy, into heaven. In April's memory. Are we ready? Let them go.
Let them go, buddy.
Woo!
Checkmate your children. Be aware of the criminals that are out there. In God's name, amen.
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 I'm in the middle right there. Yeah. That's
pretty cool.
When did we meet? I don't remember.